واعتز بالله عز وجل بيهم انهم منحوني ثقه وانه انا الله قدرني اصل اوصل للعائلات هاي المستوره.
الحمد لله الحمد لله يا رب.
Two organizations who have formed a close bond are making a significant difference. Working together, they give goats and bees to those most in need in Jordan.
Our collaboration with all the charities is very important for us because they are the ones keeping the projects and helping the poor people.
70% of the assistance through this project went to mothers who were really rather desperate in terms of taking care of their families. Best example was a lady that was named Hajar. She was a single mother living in a small cinder block shed with six children. She received two goats. And then 2 years later, the flock had increased to six goats. The milk and yogurt and cheese she was able to produce gave her enough income that she could move into the house that was propping up the shed. So she was able to pay rent and send her children to school and basically take care of her family.
بقول الله يجزيهم الخير ووفقهم ربنا والله ربنا إن شاء الله ميزانات حسناتكم.
Goats are good at not only making milk but making other goats. The type of goat that our partner selected was known for producing twins. The milk production was actually double. So over time, their flocks increased. They went from refugee status to being able to take care of themselves. The best point of this project is that they really know how to take care of goats and make them productive. All they need is the basic resource to get started. There are 135 families that have received milk goats.
We were able to find through our partner, JAHUTH, that the beehives could be a very good project for refugees to earn money with. But they needed training. And we found out that the Ministry of Agricultural Extension Center, which was in a very destitute area of Jordan, where a lot of refugees are and very poor Jordanians, that they would give them the classes for free.
One of the examples was a young man from Aleppo, Syria. He came to Jordan as a refugee with his family.
أول ما أجيت كنت عايش بصعوبة. أول شيء اضطراب نفسي. نسبة النفسية كانت 0%. ربي أي شيء أستطيع أني أقوم فيه. اني اكون اشوف حالي ناجح فيه فعرضوا علي صندوق النحل كل خليه تقريبا فيها لحد 30 35 40 الف نحله تقريبا قدرت اني اجيب الماكينه تبع التفريز كنت انا اضطر اني اروح ادفع فلقيت انه في منه فائده والحمد لله يعني مثل ما انتم شايفين استفدت واهتميت فيه.
He done a good job of taking care of the bees and selling the honey and 2 years later he had 4 beehives but also he was able to move his family into a house and sent his children to school.
بفتخر انه صار في عنده موتوج، صار في عنده مردود، صار في عنده حياه ثانيه حتى بقدر اعيشها يعني مع النحل. مآمن برب العالمين انه هو اللي راح يبعث لي شيء مشان اطفالي، مشان يعني هو بيسير اموري وانا لازم اسير فيها لحتى اصل للنجاح او شبه مصنع من منتجات الخليه.
This young man volunteered to train other new beekeepers in how to take care of bees. That's the kind of thing we see through Latter-day Saint Charities projects, is that it strengthens the partners and the communities as well as the individual beneficiaries.
فالله عز وجل يكون في عونه ونحن كلنا أخوة كلنا من آدم وحواء يكون الله عز وجل في عون العبد ما دام العبد يكون في عون أخيه.
They are very very happy and when you are seeing they're smiling you are be very happy.
You see the light of Christ in these people's eyes. They are uplifted by the same force that motivates all men to do good.
طبعا الانسان بيتبسط وبيقول الحمد لله وبتسامه كلش